edvectorvideo.com. Thank you.
Hello guys, Dr. Carlo here, Medical Director at Cartersville Medical Center. Today, we were on the quality variance meeting where we discussed core measure failures, DVT, VT prophylaxis, antibiotics before surgery, anything that's quality measures that we might have some opportunity to improvement. And we were talking about falls within the hospital, most of which applies to inpatients, patients who are registered already as patients in the ER or as inpatients. But it came to me that we also have falls from family members, and especially people who pass out during procedures. And I thought to myself that there's really no policies or procedures regarding what do you do when you have two or three family members all watching the little kid getting sedated for laceration repair, or somebody who's getting a venipuncture, puncture, actually any kind of procedure which a family member could react to. We all have had the experience where we're doing a laceration, all of a sudden the family member says, oh, I feel dizzy. You're doing the procedure, they gotta like go to pass out. You can't even help them because you got all sterile and whatnot, or maybe you break field and help them, but they might fall there, might hit the head. There might be a bad outcome from a fall or injury. And we definitely want to diminish the possibility of this happening. So there is no guideline or procedures regarding this, but I would like to make a motion that we do. If you're gonna do any procedure, venipuncture, NG tube, laceration repair, a conscious sedation procedures, not that you can't have family members there, I encourage it. They should have family members to help you out to, appease the patient and make him calm or whatever. But if they're there and they're watching the procedure being done, they should be sitting in a chair or sitting in the floor if they want to. But the point is, if they were to get dizzy, lightheaded, feel like they're gonna pass out, and they do, they're not gonna hurt themselves. So this is a general recommendation. It is not a policies and procedures, but I'm gonna try to move forward in making it a standard policy of the ER that if there are any family members and a procedure is being performed, that they be in the sitting position, or they need to move outside the room to avoid potential falls and injuries. Got a big kudos by administration. It seems like the Foley catheter utilization from the ER has diminished to the point they've noticed that the number of Foley catheters coming into the ICU or PCU or regular floor are much less than they used to be. Remember that Foley catheters are convenient but not required in many patients that we used to put catheters in. And the problem is that if you put it in and it results in a urinary tract infection, then the complications of that treatment will not be paid for by Medicare, Medicaid, things like that. Not only that, but it's an adverse quality measure. It makes us look bad. So remember, just a patient is too weak to get up and go, it's not good of an excuse. Measure of INOs is not a good excuse. When you order a Foley catheter on CPOE, there's a set of rules there. That comes straight from, I'm not even sure where it comes from, CMS guidelines or something like that. But if you can't find one of those reasons to meet the reason why you're putting that catheter on that patient, you got to rethink putting that Foley catheter in. They probably do not need it. And this is not just because we're being lazy and we don't want to put that catheter, but really because if it were to result in an infection on that patient, one, we've caused that infection. That's really what it's all about. But second, it would result in quality measures and adverse infections that were not there to begin with. So just because the patient's getting Lasix and they're too big to really get into a commode is not a good excuse. And if you put the catheter in because you needed to measure volume or whatever, but you're done, remove the catheter before they go upstairs. Thank you. That's it for this video. We'll see you next time.